first identify what is it that you love to do, what is your passion, and what is it that you like doing. So after that only would you be able to decide upon which stream or which line would you like to get into. That is when you be certain that this is the specialization that I would like to do, and that is how you go about doing a specialization in whichever university that you wish. And yes, I would like to ask Nityansh, when exactly did you realize that you should quit your job and pursue masters?
As far as I remember, I have a couple of friends, Nayan Chaudhary and Nitin Srivastava, both are ex-GRE students and both are in US University. So I got into talking with them and what work I was doing. So it was, as far as I remember, March of 2014 where I decided that I want to pursue something in this field. And for that, I started planning my GRE.
Okay, well, that's good to know that
Yeah.
two of your friends who were GRE as students motivated you to go about and pursue your
Yeah.
master's. What is that one thing that drew, that was the driving force for you behind deciding that yes, I want to do specialization in the analytics field?
So I would like to start with quoting a gentleman called as James. He is the CEO of Netscape Navigator. He said that if you have data, so let's talk about data, and if you have opinion, let's go with mine.
Okay.
So I was pretty actually motivated by that, and that actually triggered that I wanted to have scientific approach to problem solving.
Well, Nityansh, over here I would like to ask you, how many universities that you get did you get an admit from?
So I got an admit from four universities. The one I'm currently in, Georgia Tech. Other is Texas A&M. One is University of Michigan, Dearborn, and the
Okay. Well, Nityansh, now that we know that you have joined Georgia Tech, okay, so which stream would you be specializing in?
So I'm specializing in business analytics. So it's a stream. So since I was working, I actually realized that if you want to solve a business problem with data, you need four things. You need a business understanding of the problem. You need certain coding skills to code your ideas. You need a knowledge of statistics to interpret the result and actually run models. And you need a certain knowledge of modeling and operations research.
So guys,
So
we shall be starting
I
with the way Nityansh started his preparations, okay? And what were the things that Nityansh said did in order to get a 321, okay? So yes. So Nityansh, my first question to you is, how did you plan for your GRE?
So for my GRE, I tried to cover all the topics that were in my GRE Edge package and particularly verbal. I tried to solve as many questions as I can and get a good practice of tests. Yeah, so this is how I tried to plan. I tried to one thing I did was I maintained an Excel sheet where I wrote all the words that I came across either in a GRE test or just browsing through internet or reading a book. I noted all of them in an Excel workbook, and I keep on referring to that Excel workbook whenever I had time, just to keep reminding me of the words.
So Nityaj, starting with the quants, how did you go about preparing for your quants?
So this is something that I actually regret that I didn't work well on quant. I was not happy with my quant score. I should have invested more time on quant. I was a little, I would say, reckless while doing quant. But I at the end, I start. I whenever I gave full test, I made sure that I gave quant also. But yeah, I think I'll recommend everybody and advise that it's definitely advice that don't take quant lightly. It's the most coding section, and it could seriously impact your GRE.
And yes, so let's move on to the verbal section. So Nityansh, please tell us, how did you go about preparing for your verbal section?
As I told you previously, I maintained an Excel workbook where I wrote all the words that I came across. I tried to solve each sections in my GRE package, and within the timeline also, I planned that I should be able to complete all the sections just one way before my GRE exam, and devote the last few weeks for the main papers, the full length papers. I tried solving each and every type of question, and I think verbal is something that I had to work on. If you have a reading habit, it always helps. But if you think your verbal is not up to the mark, so I think some hard work and practice would
definitely. Well, guys, I'm sure that you guys have a lot of questions related to quants and verbal, and I'm sure that Nityansh would love to answer them. However, we will take up all your questions in the Q&A session. So I request you to kindly be a bit more patient. Let's proceed to the AWS section, which I'm sure a lot of you would be eager to know. How did Nityansh manage to score well and go about preparing for the AWS section? So yes, Nityansh, how did you start preparing for an AWS section?
So I think GRE has GRE has mock test where you can answer your AWA questions. I used that. I went to the ETS website. They have very good explanation of what kind of AWA they are expecting. So they have given you what kind of answer gives you a 6, what kind of answer gives you a 5, and so on. So please read that. Will give you a very good idea of what kind of answer and what kind of analytical answer they expect from you. So yeah, that's how I prepared for AWS.
Okay, so Nityansh, here I would like you to answer me this. What was the DEED experience like? What was the experience of yours on the GRE day?
So I took an off from my office. I tried not to study much. The previous night, I just revised my Excel workbook, went to at the GRE station, GRE center, and 40 minutes early, I took my passport and invalid ID card, and I just thought that I should be focused. The main problem that I faced was that GRE is a long paper; it's 4.5 hours. And you tend to lose focus in the end sections. I think that was something that actually I also did. So I'll recommend that if you could practice for 4.5 hours while preparing for your GRE at a single stretch, that would help you a lot to maintain that focus. And the experience was pretty good.
How did you shortlist your universities?
I actually took help from Ritu, who was my POC at GREedge, and I tried to visit every website and tried to read the description of the course, what they did, how was their placement, what was the class demographic, and this is how I shortlisted few universities. I also took into account the fee structure also, so I didn't want to apply in university, which I basic approach that I chose for shortlisting the universities. At the same time, I did something. I also took into account the deadlines of each universities, and I prepared some kind of a Gantt chart that I want to complete this application part in this time, get it reviewed.
Okay, so well, Nityansh, here I would like to know a little more about the Gantt chart that you had prepared. So could you please discuss about the Gantt chart a little more?
So yeah, so those of who might be working or somebody who's from an industrial background, a Gantt chart is a chart. It's a kind of a project plan. What you do is you list down tasks and you list down the timeline. So you plan to complete this task in this particular timeline. So you list all the tasks like working on the SOP draft, getting it reviewed from GREedge, getting it reviewed from friends, incorporating all those all the feedback, then editing it yourself, and again, yeah, so that's the basic idea of a Gantt chart.
I shall I'd like to ask you, Nityansh, what were the techniques that you used for preparing the documents, the SOP and your LORs? So whom exactly did you get your LORs from?
So I had been working in the industry for the past 2 years, so I decided that I'll take one LOR from my senior manager here and two LORs from professor. So all the universities I applied in had at most three, and a few had fewer LOR requests. So I tried to have at least one professional, one academic university, not from professors and managers that I know better. So they can write a personalized LOR rather than a general one, which I think makes a better sense. And since I had worked with them, so they quoted some of the incidents that they remember. I think it helped a lot. So yeah, that's how I prepared my LORs.
Well, okay. So Nityansh, my next question to you is, how did you go about preparing your SOP?
So I think SOP is the most important document in your application, apart from the GRE score. So for SOP, I tried to formulate a story first. I started working on a draft, I think near mid-October, where I listed down what I want to write, what kind of story I want to make, and how it fits. So I completed the draft. I had a few settings, and then I sent it over to GREs to get it edited. So they did an excellent job editing it. Once I received that, I re-read it again. So many of my universities required a different version of SOP. Some required a brief, some required a comprehensive SOP, some required essays also. So I had to work on all the documents.
Well, Nityansh, moving on, I would like to ask you about your experiences in your visa interview.
So yeah, my visa interview was pretty straightforward. I didn't do anything special. I got a call from Ritu that these are the documents that I need to carry with me. These are the documents that I need to be printed. I booked a slot. I dressed formals. And it was a short interview. He asked me why this university, what are you going to do? And he asked me about the work, shortly about the work that I had done. So if you had researched earlier about the university, then you are pretty confident about what you're doing. I think it's not a big deal there.
What are the general tips that you would like to give to all the GRE aspirants on how to score well?
Try to have a small snack in between. Don't try to eat heavy. It might make you snoozy. And prepare well. Be confident. Don't actually neglect quant. It's the most scoring section. Try to score as much as possible in quant. And in verbal, try to work on your strengths. In quant, try to improve your weaknesses. So yeah, that's what I...
Okay. Well, Nityansh, as most of us know that you had joined an admission counseling program with us. So which program did you enroll for?
I think I enrolled for the full one. I actually don't remember the name exactly.
Isn't the Dream University?
Yeah, it was good... Yeah, it's the Dream University one, yeah.
Prasad Kulkarni here asks Nityansh, can you elaborate on the skills required to get into business analytics? What is the difference between business analytics and business intelligence, and what do all the universities look in a candidate for MS in business analytics?
The definite skill set for business analytics would be you should have a good knowledge about the stats of the process. You should have experience regarding what kind of models needs to be used in a certain situation. You actually need to know a computer language or a platform where you can implement your...
Okay. Well, Gaurab Dash here says, nice seminar with a nice guy. Okay. Emmanuel says, thank you so much.
Yeah.
Nishit says, thank you so much, Nityansh, for being helpful to your seminar, guys. Thanks a lot. And yes, thanks a lot, Nityansh, again, for agreeing to be one of our guests on our online seminars, even though you just landed a couple of days back at Georgia, and I'm sure that you would be having a good amount of jet lag till now. Thanks a lot again, Nityansh, and we are extremely sorry, guys, if we were not able to answer your questions. It's because of the time constraints that we were not able to do that. I request you to kindly post in your questions and send it to us at info@gredge.com. And with this, we come to the end of today's seminar.